Hi guys, Aris, Hardware Busters International. Raijintek entered the PSU market with an SFX line featuring 450 and 550 watt capacity units. I will take a look in this video at the Ermis 550B. Let me start by saying that since I'm Greek, I like the naming scheme of all Raijintek products based on Greek mythology. For those of you unaware, Ermis in Greek, or Hermes, is an Olympian god, the protector of heralds, travelers, thieves, merchants, and orators. He's also incredibly fast. He was incredibly fast. The Flash DC character and Hermes share many similarities since both are so very fast. The Ermis 550B is 80 plus bronze and cybernetics silver certified. It also has the Cybernetics A- noise certification. Raijintek used a non-modular cable configuration to reduce cost, which will probably disappoint some of you. That said, there are only a few cables because of the small form factor and the low capacity. The specifications include an 80mm sleeve bearing fan and a 3-year warranty, which is quite long for a $65 PSU. The OEM behind both Ermis units is Casecom, which also makes many co-link and aerocool units. Despite the mainstream price, in the bundle you will find an SFX to ATX adapter bracket, which will allow you to install this SFX PSU into an ATX chassis. We have a single 12-volt rail, which can deliver up to 492 watt, and the maximum power on the minor rails combined is 100 watt. All cables are short because of the small form factor, the number of EPS and PCI Express connectors is okay for this capacity, and the same goes for the SATA connectors. I would like to see 3-4 pin Molex connectors though, and not only 2. It is also a good thing that all cables are flat and stealth, since the first reduces the cable volume, allowing for increased airflow inside the chassis, while the stealth feature just looks good. Internal design. The OEM is Casecom. Under proper guidance, this OEM is capable of delivering high performance per dollar products. The PCB is small, since this is an SFX unit. The heat sinks are not that large either, and there is enough clearance between the parts for adequate airflow. The fixed cables don't significantly get in the way of airflow for the filtering caps on the secondary side, which is a good thing because it increases their lifetime. The main issue with fixed cables on PSUs is that many wires block the secondary side, messing with airflow. And on the secondary side, we have the filtering caps, which get the most stress. This is one of the main reasons I prefer modular PSUs over non-modular ones. Build quality is decent for this price range. The design is a mix of old and new elements. We find an older design with a double forward topology on the primary side. In contrast, on the secondary side, we have a synchronous design with DC-DC converters to generate the minor rails. Also, thankfully, Casecom didn't use passive parts for the 12-volt rails rectification, which would lead to increased energy losses, which means lower efficiency. In the transient filter, the lack of a metal oxide varistor or MOV is a major minus for me. The electrolytic caps on the secondary side are by Asia X. There are also three polymer caps. In general, I don't like this cap choice, but in this price range, I guess I cannot be very picky. The cooling fan is from an unknown brand. It measures 80mm across and uses a sleeve bearing, which is not ideal for PSU use. Protection features. There are several issues here. OCP at 12V is set too high. Practically, the PSU didn't shut down during this evaluation. I had to abort the test since ripple went through the roof and voltage dropped too low. Two signs of imminent failure. To make matters worse, OCP is also set too high on the minor rails for no reason at all, especially at 3.3 volt, where I applied a load of over 40 amps. It's insane to see such a high amperage on the 3.3 volt rail, especially in an SFX unit. If I continue it loading this rail more, eventually the DC-DC converters will go boom. On the other hand, OPP is set correctly, which is something at least. There's also over temperature protection, but no surge protection, since the PSU's platform doesn't have an metal oxide varistor in its transient filter. Performance. Load regulation is tight enough at 12V and 5V and average on the other two rails. Ripple suppression is not good, especially at 5V and 5VSB. On the latter rail, ripple exceeds the 50mV limit that the ATX spec sets. Transient response, not so good news here. The age of this platform is evident in the transient response tests, which are critical since the PSU will face such situations in real-life usage. All rails performed terribly here, especially 3.3V, which failed in both tests. Hold-up time exceeds 17 milliseconds and the power OK signal is accurate but below 16 milliseconds. It is nice to see a hold-up time over 17 milliseconds in such an inexpensive PSU and especially an SFX one. In-rush current is high with 230V input. EMI suppression. False pairs go over the limit with the average detector, but everything is fine with the peak EMI detector. Efficiency. In this chart, all SFX units I have evaluated belong to higher efficiency categories, so the Ermis 550B doesn't go well here since it is only bronze in 80 plus and silver in cybernetics, and I had to compare it with gold and platinum SFX units. The problem here I see is that efficiency with a 2% load should exceed 60%, since this is what the ATX spec requires. As expected, average efficiency is also low compared to the rest SFX PSUs that I have evaluated so far, which are more expensive and have higher efficiency sets. The 5SB rail is inefficient. Vampire power is, or standby power is high. It should be below 0.1 watt with both 115 and 230V input. Average power factor. At 230V input, the APFC converter performs better than other SFX units, which is a pleasant surprise. Average noise output. The Ermis unit manages to beat more efficient platforms in average noise output. Overall performance is below other SFX PSUs, which do cost more. With better ripple suppression and tighter transient response, the Ermis unit will score much higher, but both need a modern platform, especially the latter, which would increase cost. Bottom line, suppose you are covered by 100 watt less and don't mind spending $15, 15, not 50, more. In that case, you could get the Corsair SF450 Gold instead, which has a fully modular cable design, higher build quality, is supported by a longer warranty and offers notably higher performance. Compared now $15 to $65, yes, it's a significant percentage, but since the price is low, $15 more, I don't believe that it is a notable amount for you to spend to get a better PSU with 100 watt less, okay, but a much better platform. Anyway, I believe that this is a decent first try from Raijintek, and I want to see more from this brand. Now, let's go to pros and cons. I will start with the good stuff. Pros. Delivered full power at 40 degrees Celsius. It is affordable. High performance per price ratio. Properly set over power protection. There is over temperature protection. Tight enough load regulation at 12V and 5V, decent efficiency for its price, 1 EPS and 2 PCI Express connectors, hold-up time is over 17 milliseconds, PF readings with 230V input are high enough, it is not noisy under normal operating conditions, accurate power OK signal but below 16 milliseconds, adequate distance between peripheral connectors, SFX to ATX bracket in the bundle, and low leakage current. The cons list now. OCP at 12V and the minor rails is set too high. No move for surge protection, sleeve bearing fan, low quality capacitors, mediocre transient response, increased ripple on all rails, and high in-rush currents with 230 volt input. I will continue with some other not so important cons. There is no power switch, it is non-modular PSU, efficiency with a 2% load is below 60%, only two 4-pin Molex connectors, low efficiency at 5 VSB, increased vampire power and lower than 16 milliseconds power OK signal. And the last, no alternative low power mode support, which is only required by the newest ATX spec either way. This was another review by Hardware Busters International. Hope you enjoyed it. Okay, it was a PSU review. It was not a stand-up comedy, but okay. Hope you enjoyed it still. We have a Discord server if you want to get in touch with us. Patreon page if you want to support us for all the hard work we do for you guys here in Hardware Busters International. And I think I said enough. Till the next video. Bye-bye.